Hi, I'm Casey with Inspired Flight. Today, we'll be preparing for flight with the IF800 Tomcat by completing our preflight checklist. These are the recommendations from Inspired Flight, but always follow your organization's procedures and checklists. Let's start by setting up the drone. Begin by installing the landing gear while the drone is still in the case. Insert the legs until the retention pin clicks into place. Next, pull the drone up and out of the case using the landing gear. With the aircraft now upright, remove the propeller locks and place them back into the case. Then, unfold the arms of the aircraft and twist each locking mechanism until a solid, continuous orange line is formed. Unfold each propeller and check for any damage and ensure the motors rotate freely. Then, fully tighten the ratchet clamp on each landing gear. To attach the payload, locate the red dovetail clamp and move it into the open position. Slide the payload in until it clicks in place, and move the red dovetail clamp to the lock position. The IF800 requires two IB388 smart batteries for flight. To install the batteries, first activate them by pressing the center button on each battery. A flashing green light will indicate that the batteries are awake and activated. Now slide the batteries into the drone and twist the lock to fully secure. You may notice after installing the batteries that one battery is now solid blue light. This is normal and indicates the battery is activated. Now, let's prepare the ground control station before powering on the aircraft. In this video, we'll be flying the HearLink. Unfold the antennas and ensure they are fully connected. Never power on the controller without the antennas. Then, power on the controller and launch Inspired Ground Control. Now, hold the power button on the aircraft for about 3 seconds to power on the IF800. Allow the vehicle to download its parameters indicated by the green loading bar at the top of the screen. The aircraft in GCS will now perform its startup sequence with audible tones, lights, and a gimbal self-test. Now, let's verify the battery status, video feed, and GPS connection in IGC. At the top of the app, we can see our GPS connection. We want to be connected to 10 or more satellites and have a horizontal dilution of precision, or HDOP, less than 1. This is indicated next to the satellite icon. Then, check the battery percentage next to the battery icon. You can press the battery icon for more details about each battery. We recommend flying with fully charged batteries and that both batteries are showing similar voltage. If the voltage values differ significantly, the vehicle will fail a pre-arm check and a notification will display on the screen. If this occurs, you will need to charge the batteries. Confirm remote ID is active from the green exclamation mark on the screen. We'll cover remote ID specifics in another video. The IF800 has a built-in FPV camera, and the payload we are using, the Gremsy VO-F1, has a thermal and optical camera. You can cycle through the cameras on the right side of the IGC app by pressing 1 for the FPV camera or 2 for the payload camera. On this payload, you can also tap the EO button to switch over to the IR camera and vice versa to switch back. Next, verify the attitude and compass orientation. While holding the controller for easy visibility, tilt the aircraft slightly. The gauges on the screen should reflect those movements. Then rotate the aircraft. I recommend placing the controller on top of the aircraft and rotating slightly while viewing the gauges on the screen. The aircraft is now in a ready state and IGC is reporting ready to fly at the top left of the screen. Now that we've performed the pre-flight checklist, we can clear the launch area and proceed with our mission. To start the motors, move the left command stick down and to the right until the controller says armed. Recenter the sticks once the motors are idling. If you need to disarm before taking off, move the left command stick down and to the left until the vehicle disarms. That concludes our pre-flight checklist, and we're ready to take off. Check out our next video for takeoff and landing procedures.